Michael Raines, Expert Village. Now, I'm going to give you an introductory lesson. Now, let me just try that again. Michael Raines, Expert Village. Now, before we get started on installing this X10 system, I got to explain to you how electricity works and what it does. But first, I got to explain to you the tools necessary to install this system. So, we'll start with the basics. Obviously, screwdrivers, Phillips, flat screwdriver, who doesn't have one? Now, needle nose, you remember these guys, may come in handy. Now, the one specialty tool you don't have is the wire strippers. You're gonna need this because the insulation on the wiring is tough. You're gonna need some strippers. Don't use diagonal cutters or dykes as they're called. You're just gonna end up messing up the wire because if you score the wire, it snaps off. It's only copper, okay? Next specialty tool. This is commonly known as a tester. There's a little neon bulb in here. You plug this into the wall socket, lets you know if you're live or not, if you have current. Now, the most basic system and tool used is your regular voltmeter or a multimeter. It'll do DC, AC, amps, whatever. Might be handy to have, but you can get away with a little test module. And that's what you need to put in most basic lighting and the X10 remote control system. So, that's what we have. We're missing one little part though. Safety glasses. Remember, I'm the safety Nazi. You gotta be safe. They don't look cool, they protect my eyeballs. Because when you're working on electrical above your head, crap will fall in your eyes and it's not a pleasant experience. Trust me, I've done it. Wear some kind of eye protection at all times whenever you're working on anything in front of your face or above your head. You'll be thankful and you won't have to go to the eye doctor like I did. So, let's move on to basic electricity.